Welcome to Horse Guards Parade. I am Charles Collingwood and will be guiding you through this unique piece of ceremonial theatre. And to begin proceedings, 30 members of the Corps of Drums now march out from Horse Guards playing drum solos, Albany's and Illawarra. The Corps of Drums are the oldest branch in the Royal Marines, as 6 drummers were present when the Corps was formed as the Duke of York's and Albany's Maritime Regiment of Foot some 352 years ago in 1664. Retreat was the name given to the beating of drums carried out under the leadership of the drum major, or later the bugle major, which took place at the end of the day. It was the signal that ordered troops to cease fire and to retire to their camp, as well as warning the sentries to stand guard until next morning when reveille was sounded. The various drum beatings known as retreat beatings, together with the sounding of sunset, are at the core of the major ceremony now known as beating retreat. The massed bands are marching up from Wellington Barracks to Horse Guards Parade, led for the first time by their new Corps Drum Major, Warrant Officer 2 Buster Brown, who has choreographed all the drill movements that will be carried out by the massed bands. Led by the Corps Bugle Major, Warrant Officer 1 A.J. Piner, the buglers announced the arrival of the massed bands with the fanfare indefatigable. Playing Richard Waterer's stirring march, Gibraltar, the massed bands of 220 musicians and buglers lead the 14-piece fanfare team and the 96 members of the Guard of Honour onto the parade ground. Thank you. The Guard of Honour is made up from officers, warrant officers, non-commissioned officers, and Marines from 4-5 Commando, 40 Commando, and Commando Logistics Regiment Royal Marines, under the command of Major Paul Forrest. The Queen's and the regimental colours are held by Royal Marines units. The Queen's colour is the symbol of the sovereign and the country, whereas the regimental colour is the emblem of the soul of the regiment. For today's event, it will be the Queen's colour of 4-5 Commando Royal Marines that will be carried on the parade. Throughout history, unit colours were very important, especially during the heat of the battle. Troops would need to know who they should follow and where they should be. Nowadays, this whole ceremony is one of symbolic trust and reverence. Protected by a guard of 96 ranks, the colour has an additional protection. This is the colour party that consists of the officer for the colour and two escorts. The officer is usually a junior officer who will carry the colour, and the two escorts are senior colour sergeants, and they will march either side of the officer who is carrying the colour as protection. The massed bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines have performed the ceremony of beating retreat on Horse Guards Parade since 1950, when they first performed for Queen Mary, and they've done so at regular intervals ever since. With the colour party, Guard of Honour, and mass bands now settled on the parade, they await the arrival of His Royal Highness the Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, the Captain General of the Royal Marines. Captain General, His Royal Highness the Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, is greeted by the Defence Secretary Michael Fallon, the Second Sea Lord Vice Admiral Jonathan Woodcock, and the Commandant General Royal Marines Major General Martin Smith. The Guard of Honour will now move to the rear of the parade and take up their position in front of the Guards' Memorial, leaving the performance area clear for the massed bands. who are formed from all five Royal Marines bands, Portsmouth, Plymouth, Collingwood, the Commando Training Centre Royal Marines, and the Scotland Band. They are under the command of the Principal Director of Music Royal Marines, Lieutenant Colonel Nick Grace, OBE. The fanfare team of 14 Marine trumpeters march forward to take up their position for the opening fanfare that will welcome the Captain General onto the dais, from where he will watch the ceremony and eventually take the salute at the end of the parade. The Principal Director of Music now conducts the opening fanfare, Scarpa Flow. A 100 years ago, the British Grand Fleet, under the command of Admiral Sir John Jellicoe, sailed from its base at Scarpa Flow to engage the German High Sea Fleet at the Battle of Jutland. Thank you. Earl Mountbatten presented the musical score of the Preobrajensky March to the Corps in 1964, as his uncle, the Grand Duke Sergius, once commanded the Russian Preobrajensky Guards. The march is now the regimental slow march of the Royal Marines. Composed by Sir Vivian Dunn, the Captain General March was first performed on the 19th of December 1949 in the Savoy Hotel at a dinner attended by King George VI, who was the Captain General at the time. When King George V visited Royal Marines training at Deal in 1918, he was so impressed that he directed that the senior recruit squad should be called the King's Squad. Guard now moves into position for their drill display, which is similar to the displays carried out every 2 weeks at the Royal Marines Commando Training Centre by the King Squad during their pass-out parade after 32 weeks of the most arduous military training in the UK Armed Forces. very impressive display by Royal Marine commandos, who are more used to being deployed on operations than performing arms drill displays on the parade ground. They now march to Kenneth Alford's On the Quarterdeck, composed in 1917, commemorating the Battle of Jutland of the previous year. Composed 2 years ago for the 350th anniversary of the Royal Marines, the Slow March, Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, draws on some familiar tunes from the Royal Marines and the Royal Navy. Composed in 1972, the Mountbatten March is dedicated to Earl Mountbatten, who was a Colonel Commandant of the Royal Marines, during which the massed bands now perform one of their more complicated movements, the four-way split. Of drums now move forward to the tune British Grenadiers, which precedes the playing of the traditional divisional calls of the original Royal Marine Divisions, Chatham, Portsmouth and Plymouth. This is followed by the band and bugle fanfare, Salute to the Corps. The Corps of Drums then perform the centrepiece of tonight's ceremony, the actual beating retreat, with an impressive display of drumming and movement. stunning display by the Corps of Drums, who now rejoin the massed bands to the march Soldiers of the Sea, written in 1960 for the Royal Navy's first commando carrier, HMS Bulwark. You might just hear references to the tune A Life on the Ocean Wave. Music now by the film composer Howard Shaw and his Lord of the Rings, where the massed bands will demonstrate not only their musical skill, but also their concentration in maintaining formation as a massed band. This stylish Russian march was composed by Alexandra Pakhmutova and dedicated to Marshal Zhukov, who was a key figure in World War II and participated in the signing of the German Instrument of Surrender in 1945. led by Major Forrest, the guard will now unfix their bayonets in preparation for a celebratory ripple of fire.
The Royal Guard will unfix bayonets! Unfix! Guard, bayonets! Guard, done! The Royal Guard will conduct a celebratory ripple of fire! Guard, loot! Present! Commence! Royal Guard, shoulder up! The Royal Guard will fix bayonets. Guard, fix! Guard, bayonets! Roll call! Slow! Up!
The principal director of music now moves forward, saluting the colour as he passes it, and reports to the Captain General, asking permission to play the national anthem and to march the guard and mast bands off the parade.
Your Royal Highness, that completes ceremonial beaching retreat by the mast bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines. May I have your permission to play the national anthem and march the guard and the mass bands off the parade? Thank you very much, sir.
To the Royal Navy's march past Heart of Oak, the guard, fanfare team and mast bands prepare to march past the saluting dais to the regimental march past of the Royal Marine Commandos, Sarry Marais, and the regimental march past of the Royal Marines, A Life on the Ocean Wave. Marching into the bright light of the setting sun, the massed bands and guard march back to barracks. I hope you have enjoyed another superb evening of ceremonial theatre by the Royal Marines.